Data centers may be powerhouses of the digital economy, but they come in all shapes and sizes, with different service models, different business models, and different locational advantages. Dot Magazine asked Dr. Béla Waldhauser from the Alliance for the Strengthening of Digital Infrastructures in Germany to unravel the complexities and explain what kind of customer business cases are most appropriate for what kind of data centers.
So, first of all, let me focus on colocation data centers. Colocation is very simple. We have the big building. We are supplying power, cooling, security. That's it. Our customers are bringing in their own IT and telco equipment. So that's what I would like to talk about in the next few minutes. We have a concentration of fairly big data centers, of those kind of colocation data centers, in the tier one cities like London, Paris, Amsterdam, Frankfurt, and in the meantime also Dublin, by the way. These kind of data centers are for any kind of customers. I mean, we have very small customers, 1, 2, 3, 4x, usually carriers providing connectivity, because those data centers with hundreds of customers usually are a marketplace. They're a marketplace in itself, an ecosystem, so to say. So we attract enterprises, public sector, finance sector, corporates, but also carriers and cloud players. If we are talking about the latest 2, 3, 4 years, then more and more cloud providers are coming to Europe in order to provide their cloud services. And usually they use our colocation data centers to start with, which is part of the growth we have at the moment, because these cloud providers, they are taking up 3, 4, 5 megawatt and even more. So that's part of the growth. But I've just signed a big deal with an automotive supplier, a German one, for Frankfurt, because they did the traditional make or buy decision and they decided to buy the data center, but still own their own IT and operate the IT. So this is fundamentally the business case, and honestly speaking, we cannot build fast enough. So demand at the moment is much higher than supply. So the business case is very simple. We just need the money, building permission, just to build it. And then it's, in most cases, filled up already before we are even ready for service.
But what about data centers outside of the main digital hubs?
On the other hand, we have smaller data center providers, usually not in the tier one cities, but maybe tier two or tier three. The prime example in Germany is Norris Networks, which are based in Nuremberg, but they are not a pure colocation provider. They do that business as well, but they're also a managed service provider focusing on regional enterprises, public sector as well, but mostly enterprises, providing them a much wider range of services. So it's not just building, power, cooling, security. Then edge is a buzzword. At the moment, I don't see edge data centers at the moment, 2080, but we'll see more the need for more edge data centers in the near future. Not because, from my point of view, most Internet of Things applications need a very low latency. If you think about your fridge connected to the internet, the fridge and yourself, you don't care about latency. But if you're talking about 5G, connected cars, autonomous driving, smart city, these are real applications for very, very low latency. That means you need processing units, storage units, small data centers all across the country. This is true for all countries. It's not German or Europe specific, this is globally. So we will see more of these edge data centers, however they are, maybe containerized, whatever, in the near future with the deployment of 5G. But also Industry 4.0 is latency sensitive. So you will have in a factory, You need a data center for latency sensible applications. I think you will see the whole range of small data centers, maybe at the edge, medium-sized data centers, maybe regional, bigger data centers in the big hubs, where, for example, you have the big internet exchanges like DE-CIX in Frankfurt, or M6 in Amsterdam, or Lynx in London, and you will see the hyperscaler data centers. If you look at the press, then the hyperscaler data centers are mostly placed in Scandinavia, Dublin, if we are talking about Europe. And there's not a clear definition of hyperscale data centers, but maybe 100 megawatt and above, I would call a hyperscale data center. And if you look at the analyst reports, then more and more data will be processed and stored in these hyperscale data centers. And from a German point of view, I'm not happy that we don't have any hyperscale data center at the moment in Germany. So I think we need these hyperscale data centers as well. Digital sovereignty is one of the buzzwords, because my personal preference is to have the data in Germany and not somewhere else. If I'm looking at all these different kind of digitalization, like 5G, like connected cars, autonomous driving, smart city, IoT, the amount of data processed and stored will increase substantially, and therefore the need for new data centers. So I think for the next 5 to 10 years, we will see another big growth in the data center arena.
Thinking about the small and medium-sized regional data centers, we asked Dr. Waldhauser if there is a need for them to take a new strategic approach in order to remain successful and build their business cases.
As long as these regional data centers focus on regional enterprises, I think they will be successful. But in addition to pure colocation, they need to offer additional services. And that's the reason I've mentioned earlier Noah's Networks in Nürnberg, because they are providing a much broader scale of services to their customers. and I think a prime example of these, I would not call them data center providers, more managed service provider, is to help the medium-sized enterprises or small enterprises in the regions on their way to digitalize their business, because that's where we are lacking, not only in Germany, but in Europe. A lot of these medium-sized enterprises don't know how to digitalize their business, and they will be eaten up if they don't do that, because digitalization is very disruptive, so you need to be very fast, and these businesses, these suppliers can support these small and medium enterprises.
So opportunities abound for all types of data centers, both big and small. The trick is to think strategically and, for operators of smaller data centers, to provide the expertise your customers need to cope with digital transformation.